A very special member of the class of 2012 is with us today in spirit. Angela Shireen August passed away in a tragic car accident last Monday, June 11th, 2012. As an accomplished singer and performer graduating with summa cum laude honors, she exemplifies what it meant to be a Thurgood Marshall scholar and citizen. Today we, family, friends, and community, recognize and celebrate the life of Angela August.
So we take a moment to honor the life and to present posthumously a certificate for Angela Shireen August.
Why do bad things happen to good people? I doubt if there is a single one of us here this afternoon who has not asked that question of ourselves in one form or another since we learned of Angela's tragic death last Monday.
Thanks for all you've done. I've missed you for so long. I can't believe you're gone. You still live in me. Feel you in the wind. You guide me constantly. I never knew what it was to be alone, no. 'Cause you were always there for me. You were always the waiting.
Oh, it's only
that sets me free. I sing it wild. I feel I can hold on. I sing tonight, 'cause it comforts me.
Tell my brother not to cry, Mom. Tell Daddy to be brave. And when I go to heaven, Mom, put Daddy's girl on my grave.
Reenacted a Borat scene and in the restaurant, and my mom and my brother were there, and they were so shocked. They didn't even know what to do. They were just like mouth open.
And on the chest of that gingerbread man were two mounds of frosting with a red hot on each mound. And my mom took a look at it and she said, "You're gonna need to eat that before her mom comes in, before your mom comes in."
When we're out, she disappears somewhere. She's out in the tree picking berries. Up in the tree, eating berries. So we go down to the swimming hole, and there's a berry tree down there. Instead of her swimming, she's up in that tree eating them berries.
You know, this is your guinea pig. This is your Christmas present. I want you to have it. What do you choose a name for it? And then she says, "Bacon."
We all ended up in a bathtub together for about 3 hours trying to get all the pokies out of our bodies.
I learned so much from her. Everything from like how to paint my nails and wear eyeliner to how to be vegetarian.
She never gave up no matter what. She always persevered.
She graffitied the church walls and then set the bunnies free.
And I kind of nudge Angela, I'm like, "Angela, are we going the right way?" looks up from the book, looks left,
looks right.
Yeah, no, we're going the right way. Keeps reading the book. I was like, get a freaking map.
And yeah, as it turns out, we were like 60 miles past where we were supposed to go.
The first real fond memory with Angela was when you invited me along with your family to go to Six Flags. Everyone was tired, and Angela, she fell asleep and was resting her head on my shoulder, and it just really made me, you know, feel like part of the family, and that's how I've always felt ever since.
I watched the kids grow up through the eyes of their mother. She always bragged about them. She loved them.
Angela was not only my daughter, she was my friend. And there's just no words to describe how much I loved her, and I knew that she loved me.
She was a caring person, and always was trying to help each other and do the right thing, even when it was hard, and would reach out to others who other people wouldn't. And it was an admirable quality, one which I wish I had.